Lamont is here. Dante's here. It's Foolishness Friday. And joining us from Wednesday, Friday's different vibe. She's got on her makeup, her earrings. She done put on a little something. I feel like, Dante, this might be for you. I'm not sure, though.
I don't know.
Broadway
I
diva.
Lamont and Dante today.
Wait, what? Hold on, what now?
Yes.
I got choices. I got Lamont and Dante.
Well, hey. Lamont is taking.
Why not make the choice?
You better choose right.
You kind of want to keep them. You know, this is a polyamorous world.
Yeah. Is it? When did that happen? All right, let me welcome Tonya Pinkins. She needs no introduction. She's here. She's here. There we go.
I like the hair, Tonya.
Thank you.
Just want to rub your head.
Come rub my head, please. Are we going to talk about good luck to you, Leo, what's his name? Leo Grande.
Yeah, we're going to talk about all of that. Just a second. And actually, there's not enough distance in age between y'all for it to be the same situation. But let me just say this. let me say this to you, Dante and Tonya. I don't know how sexy it is to have a threesome with two guys as a woman.
Oh yeah.
I sound sexy to me.
That sounds sexy to you?
Oh yeah.
Wait, is it sound or can you verify or confirm?
I like the idea of it. And I would actually say three.
Three men? What?
One can be a girl, actually. Three people and me. One can be a girl.
Okay, listen, that's just two couples having sex.
I mean,
no. Everybody's serving me.
Nice.
What? Wait a minute, Tonya. Hold up.
Tonya is queen of the damned.
Lamont, hold on. You definitely could come in, but I just have one salient question.
I could come in.
Tonya Pinkins, have you ever, I don't know, we learned some things, had multiple partners at once?
No, it's my fantasy.
Okay. So that's right. A fantasy. Your fantasy is two men and another woman. What are they all doing? I'm just, in your mind, what are they doing?
You want me to say it?
Yeah, it's Friday. Hold on. If you have children in the car, first of all,
listener discretion is advised.
They shouldn't be here on Friday. You already know. We allow the first hour a 10-year-old Solomon.
Yeah, what's Solomon? Tell Solomon,
put your fingers in your ear.
Yeah.
I want the front and the back and the top.
So who's doing what? Come on.
Wait, Lindsay's like, I agree.
What? All right.
Lindsay, who's doing what I'm talking about?
Lindsay, y'all freaks. Okay. So who's doing what?
I got anal. I got the girl doing the cunnilingus and I'm kissing a guy too.
Oh, that's not what I thought. All right. Well, that's a little different.
Yeah. that's a circus.
Now everybody's serving me.
We thought you were talking about the devil's triangle.
Wait, Dante, please, Dante.
He wanted something in my mouth.
Not kissing.
Oh, okay. One in the ass, one in the pussy, one in the mouth. It's otherwise known as airtight.
Airtight. Airtight can work too. I can try that. That's a good fantasy. Airtight sounds good.
All right.
Okay. Well, Tonya already said she's not doing sperm. So how's that going to work? For her birthday. Yeah. I think that was just for that weekend.
I think that was just for that weekend.
Okay. No sperm. Her birthday.
Well, we don't want no sperm after Roe v. Wade got turned over anyway. Yeah. So,
but Leo Grande inspired me.
So Tonya, what is it about this that I watched it? I didn't feel the same way that you did. But tell me what you felt when you watched this movie.
Well, I felt like I would have been her, totally. I would have been wanting to do all this talking. I would have wanted to make sure it was politically correct, making sure he wasn't being, you know, trafficked, you know, wanting to know that he was a human being. I would have been like being a mother. And I love the fact that he was like, honey, please don't do all that. This is my job. This is what I do, and setting the boundaries. So I loved all that. And I just got inspired. You know, I've been looking to hire someone for some time. Everybody always tells me they're going to tell me somewhere to go. Mrs. Smith, if you don't know that movie, Mrs. Smith, Jessica Chastain, that was my first inspiration. So
to hire somebody to do what?
Lamont, I got you. Don't worry.
Oh, okay. What's this movie about?
So let me talk. Wait, hold on. Wait a minute. So Lamont, the movie is stars Emma Thompson, who plays a former school teacher. Okay. Her husband has died and she's by herself. She's only slept with that husband her whole life. So
never had an orgasm
and all this. They got children, which to me, I think is almost sinful to have children and not have had an orgasm. Like that's, there's something wrong with that, but that happens to women all the time because they don't advocate for themselves. Wait a minute, Tonya, you're going to get in. So Lamont, so what happened is she got this, this escort. So think Pretty Women. And he's sexy, he's chocolatey, but he's beige like you and Dante. Beige guy, and she has a list of things she wants to try that she's never done. She doesn't think she's going to have an orgasm, but she's like, I want to do anal, I want to give a blowjob, I want to, like, she's got all these things. And so he's expensive, so she has a couple of sessions set up, and they go through, but she gets a little too personal. I'm not going to give away too much.
Okay,
but
okay.
They end up doing her list. So He's a prostitute.
Yeah, prostitute. And she's say it like that. Yeah,
yeah, I'm gonna say it regular.
He's a hooker.
So Tonya, you would hire somebody? Are you in the market to hire somebody?
Absolutely. I understand. You are paying them to go away.
Tell that.
Okay, yes. Yeah. So, you know, I've been looking at the different sites and this coming Monday, I'm not paying for that, but I'm going to pay someone to come and do tantric massage. My girlfriend, when she visited me before, she hired him, but she was here by herself. And I was like, I'm not, you know, feeling it by myself. So I have another girlfriend coming over. She's going to stay in the house to be the chaperone. And so we'll see how that goes.
Like those dudes on Instagram that with the feel up, is that the feel up massage?
You know, they told me about little Popo Land or something in Atlanta. And yeah, I looked at him and that did not look sensual to me.
Cracking your back.
Atlanta for Popo Lala. And yeah. I was like, Popo Lala is not sensuous looking to me. That just looks like a regular strong massage.
Well, strong, so, with a hand in the crease and all that.
And tell you how it was. He's supposed to just, you know,
tantrically massage you. All right, Dante, who is the only person in the room that has experience both with threesomes, foursomes, fivesomes, and twelvesomes. I think he talked about a twelvesome.
Yeah,
12-some.
The dirty baker's dozen.
The baker's dozen. Not to be confused with a Dutch oven, but
or
Dante,
steamer.
All of that, which I don't know what that is. Okay, well, now we're just getting into some dirty areas here.
I was once engaged to a tantrika, and he could make me come fully clothed. He could just move my
without touching you, right? That's what tantric is, right?
Well, with the needles? I mean, he wouldn't be using his hands or anything. He might be lying on me, and he could move my energy, and I'd be fully clothed. So, which he told me, he said, the reason most people don't have good sex is everybody's trying to do everything. He says there has to be a giver and a receiver, and you have to keep switching off on that. When one is receiving, the other one has to be giving, and then you have to keep switching. And most people are both trying to give at the same time.
You have to have a level of selfishness at periods of time so that you can receive and be selfish enough to receive, and this is my time. And the giving is also selfish because the pleasing. It's like when you give to charity, you feel good about yourself.
That's
true. Well,
so even in generosity is selfishness.
Okay. All right. Can I just I'm gonna jump in. So there is a episode of P-Valley where I think the former bouncer Diamond is performing what looks like tantric something, maybe because he's not touching. Yeah. I love
he's doing
that.
The mojo.
He's doing the mojo, but I was, he was what trying
episode?
To really. It was the last episode, but it's not the same. So Dante, the question that I have for you, Tonya's gonna hire somebody. What advice do you give to women or to men about getting professional sexual help?
Or getting a hooker.
The hooker.
I mean, you have to be clear about what you're doing. I mean, I think Tonya's very clear about what she wants, what her objective is. I think to not think about what your objectives are and to think of it as something that it's not, and you can't be catching feelings, and you can't, because this is what they do. This is a business. You know what I mean? You can't. So being very clear about that, and you got to be honest about your own level of, I mean, a lot of people feel as though they can separate sex from real, true intimacy, and a lot of times they can't. It is an internal, you're letting somebody, you're entering somebody's body, and there's a closeness to that. And you can't deny that closeness affects it affects both parties. So I think you got to really understand what it is you're looking for. And I mean, I feel like Tonya is clear about what she's looking for. And you know, like, go ahead, you know.
And I'm like, if this works, I'm going to be like advertising for it. Like, women, you know, having sex is a matter of life and death now. Just pay someone to come and please you, because you can't afford to risk getting pregnant. Your life could be over.
Mm. Okay. Mm. We'll talk about the latest ruling with Tonya as well. Yeah. All right. So that was number four. Good luck to you, Leo Grand, on Hulu.
Good luck to you, Tonya Pinkins.
Yeah. oh, Lamont, to that. Can you film it? I feel like we have like OnlyFans opportunity fans. Here.
Yeah.
You can fund your next film.
Maybe
you
when I film. Get comfortable, this is my yeah. first time.
Yeah.
I'm going to need a lot of talking because I'm a sapiosexual. So, you know, if he's dumb, that could just take it all away from me. So, you know, we'll see how it goes. And
Dante needs a lot.
What if he comes over and has no arms? He's like one of those.
No, my girlfriend already had him. She tried
Okay.
So I have a personal recommendation. And we'll see how it goes.
Oh, that's
and
a
group. Got the hookup.
That's a group situation right there on a low.
But Lamont, yeah. The arms though, where did that? Well,
tantric. I was thinking tantric. He might be, you know, one
he
of those people.
He don't need no arms. I don't like, care about no arms. Someone's like, yeah. He might be gay. I'm like, I don't care who he likes to be with. As long as he know how to please me, that's fine.
Mm.
And okay. Anyway.
I would like to point out that two guys and one girl is a gangbang. Two girls, one guy is a threesome.
Yes.
Two guys, two girls is group sex. Any number of more guys than more than two guys and women is the orgy.
Okay.
So thank you. Thank you, Caligula. Thank you, Caligula, for clearing that up. All right.